Alright, thank you for joining me on this unboxing video. Today I am unboxing a brand spanking new PlayStation Vita game. I will be unboxing this with my Metal Gear Rising letter opener. I hardly ever use this as it's not very sharp, but I wanted to try to use it with this unboxing video for the sake of keeping the theme consistent. The game that we are unboxing today is called UnMetal, which is from PlayAsia. I pre-ordered this back in beginning of January 2021. It was supposed to release the end of March. However, I did not get the game until just a few weeks ago, which was the end of April. So I finally got it a month after I was supposed to get it. And as you can see here, like I said, the letter opener, which is supposed to be Raiden's knife, it's not very sharp. So I'm trying my best here to get this package opened with that letter opener. But it's a little bit tough, as you can see. So my apologies here while I struggle to try to get this open. But UnMetal is supposed to be a clone of Metal Gear Solid. And Metal Gear Rising is also a spin-off of Metal Gear Solid. So that's kind of why I wanted to use the letter opener here, just to make things a little bit consistent and whatnot with the themes for this. I was really excited to get this game. I haven't really seen any footage. I've only seen screenshots of it, and I knew, you know, with reading the description and other little bits of information regarding this game, that it was a clone of Metal Gear Solid. So, if anyone who knows me knows that I'm a huge Metal Gear Solid person, I'm like a fanboy. It's embarrassing, but I'm just trying to kill time while I'm working on this and struggling here. So. I'm going to go ahead and do a jump edit here. Bear with me. Upon opening the package, I am greeted with what looks like a sticker here at the top, with the game inside of it. And as far as I'm aware, there's a CD that's supposed to come with this as well. The game itself cost, I believe, $35 plus tax and shipping and handling. But here, it looks like they provided us with a mask, a face mask, which is pretty cool. So I'll probably have to put that together sometime later on. And then here, it looks like we have what looks like a ruler for reading. I guess I can use that later on. And then here we got another sticker from PlayAsia itself. So, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this, but we'll figure that out later. And then let me go ahead and look in the box to see what else we have. No, I'll just go ahead and set that aside. And here, let's go ahead and open up the plastic for the game. I don't want to mess up the plastic, just in case I want to put the game back inside later on. But I like the artwork that they did on this game. I think it looks really cool. The sticker, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this particular sticker. But it looks pretty cool. I might stick it on somewhere in my room, maybe. We'll see. But here's the back of the game. It says here that it contains the game itself, the soundtrack, a numbered certificate, and then the printed manual. It is a single-player game. Let's see here. In 1972, a crack commando squad threw you in prison for a crime you didn't commit. You promptly escaped from maximum security stockade to the underground, trying to survive. Alright. And looks like you have to have a PSN account. I'm not sure why, but we'll get to that. We're going to do some gameplay footage in this. But it'll just beat to start off with. I will actually do an official gameplay footage in a separate video, but I do want to at least make sure that it runs, starts up, and kind of go through the menus and whatnot during this this particular video after I unbox everything. But here's the side, here's the back, the top, and I'm going to go ahead and start opening it again, or opening this part of it. It's pretty cool that they were able to fit the game and the CD in this particular box. I was expecting the box to be a little bit bigger, just because, you know, CDs, it's been years since I bought a CD package, so kind of nostalgic for me getting a CD after so many years. I think the last one I got was maybe 2017, but it does say it's limited edition. Let me go ahead and see if I can try to focus this camera real quick. There we go. Alright, but it is limited edition. I think they only made 2,500 copies of this game, and apparently they're in talks of trying to get it released digitally, but with everything that's going on with Sony right now, they're saying that they're not going to accept any more uploads beyond July, which is in a few months. So, 1973 out of 2,500. So that's pretty cool. I'll go ahead and set that aside, though, and it has the same image on the back as it did on the sticker. Here we have the game itself. So over here looking like Snake. As I said, this is definitely a clone of Metal Gear Solid. Let me try to focus this camera again. But it looks like Roy Campbell right there in the Kodak screen. There we go. It's focused again. I'm liking the screenshots here. Nice little 2D aspect of it. So I'm looking forward to really playing this and testing it out here. But as you can see here, we got the CD that comes on the bottom side of this box, and composed by Jose Jaime Hidalgo de la Torre. I don't know. I'm sorry if I butchered your name. I do really apologize. But there's 25 tracks. I'm not sure if I'm going to open this, or I'm just going to leave it in its package, because I don't see myself listening to the soundtrack in this. If I play through the game and I really like the music, I might go ahead and open this, but I don't see myself, at least anytime in the near future, opening the soundtrack here. Let me go ahead and start opening the game, and then we'll go from there. Alright, and here we have the manual showing you how to remove the cartridge from the box and to insert it into your Vita. Some basic controls as well, and the names of the buttons. And here we have the commands as well on how to play the game. So, looks like it starts you off with a little bit of an inventory as well. Alright, so now I want to go ahead and take the game out of the package, or out of the case, I should say. And I should have probably cut my nails before I started recording, but can't go back on it now. Now I'm going to go ahead and put it into the Vita here. I'm sorry that the screen is so freaking dirty. I did not think to clean it off before I started recording either. bear with me because I will soon be switching this over to screen capture, or game capture, I should say. But I just want to make sure that I can pop this in and get it and make sure it works in the system as well. All right, so let's go ahead and turn this on real quick. All right, why is it not turning on? That's weird. All right, there we go. There's life. There's life in the Vita. These are all good signs. All right, and it's installing. That's a good sign. UnMetal. All right. So let's pop it up. See if there's any updates. Because I know there's some games you have to update them first. Looks like somebody on my friends list has purchased the game and started it. It looks like. So let's go ahead and look at that real quick. PS Vita at 2 a.m. Of course he would get this game. Alright, if you've never heard of PS Vita at 2 a.m., he's a pretty interesting dude. I like watching his videos. He's a little quirky. Looks like there's no updates to the game though. So we're going to go ahead and get this started. Alright, so now we're starting the game. And I wanted to switch over to the screen capture so that way it's full screen and you're not looking at my dirty Vita screen. Oh man, I'm excited. I'm really excited to get this started. I've been waiting. Alright, I like the intro so far. It's simple but pretty cool. I always also like to look at the options before I start any game. Just because that's how I roll. I don't want to do anything with the controls, languages. I want to keep it in English for sure. Okay. They don't have many options. Trophies. Huh. Okay. Alright, well, the only option is to start the game. Let's go ahead and... Let's see, they have easy, medium, hard. I'm gonna start easy.
Once upon a time, a Soviet war helicopter entered Allied territory. The aircraft was intercepted and shot down. As the pilot emerged from the wreckage, he was arrested by the same bastards who shot him down.
Damn.
And later was brought to a military base for interrogation. That pilot was me.
Name?
My name is Fox. Jesse Fox.
You don't seem to be Russian.
Russian? Me?
You were piloting a Russian aircraft 2 hours ago.
I also drive a Toyota, and I'm not Japanese.
All right, Mr. Fox. Before arresting you, I'm obligated to write down a report with your version of the facts. So tell us what the hell you were doing in that heavily armed Soviet helicopter.
It's a long story.
Sergeant? Bring us
He's
some
trying
coffee.
To sound like Snake
yes,
too.
Sir. Wachowski, bring the lieutenant some coffee.
Yes, sir.
Well, Mr. Fox, we have plenty of time. Explain what happened.
In 1972, a crack commando unit threw me in a prison for a crime I didn't commit.
You're under arrest for a crime you didn't commit!
I promptly escaped from a maximum security stockade to the underground, trying to survive from these soldiers of fortune.
I'm liking this so far. This is pretty funny.
Let's start from the beginning. How did you escape from that cell?
Piece of cake. I just had to write a note.
A note? Where'd you get the paper from?
I used toilet paper.
I see. And how did you find a pen?
A pen? I was in a dirty, grimy cell, not in an office. I wrote the note with a rusty wire. Using my own blood as ink.
Damn. That's some hardcore shit. Toilet paper. Oh Okay.
I scratched my arm with the wire and got to work.
Damn, that's some hardcore shit.
The toilet paper tore under the pressure of the bloody wire. Those bastards gave us cheap paper. One ply, unscented and unpatterned.
Why did you break the toilet? Why not grab the paper like a normal person?
You know how prison is. It's kill or be killed. And I wasn't going to be killed by some dirty toilet.
Oh, hey, you moron! Holy Jesus! You schmuck. Do you really think I'd be stupid enough to kill myself? Kill myself?
Keep X pressed close to flashing enemies to search him. He may be carrying something. A key! Yay! Okay. Select any item in the inventory. Once selected, press... Is that the square button? There we go.
I left the guard locked in the cell. Then I threw away the key and got out of there.
Mr. Fox, what about the noose? Where did you get that from?
Where did I get the noose? Are you seriously asking me that?
I am, Mr. Fox.
I'll tell you later.
All right. I'm actually going to stop it there. I don't want to get too far into this because I just wanted to do the unboxing and do an introduction of the game. I will be doing an official gameplay of the game starting back from the beginning. But this is just mostly an introduction. I was not expecting voice acting in this. This is awesome, and I cannot wait to dive into this and play this more. I know I'm supposed to be going through my Metal Gear Solid series, so I'm going to try to find time to do that as well. But I really wanted to get this out. I was really excited about it. Thank you for watching and sticking with me through this. Until the next video, peace!